What's up, guys? Ash here. Welcome to the Drone Guide Volume 1. We are going to be going over a lot of the drone basics, kind of building a drone, you know, what frame type, SP structure, operating system, output, equipment and weight. Obviously, there's so much that goes into drone building, and it is very much kind of an end game thing, and I've been asked many times to kind of do this guide, so hopefully it's going to be good, and let's hop right into it. You unlock drones as soon as you recruit Kylie, which is approximately Chapter 5, Scenario 3, Bury the Past. Kylie is a mechanical genius and as such can craft drones that can help out in a myriad of ways for fights. Primarily, they are designed for defense and choke point holding. This is what they really specialize in. As you can see here, I've got Ares, who's an incinerator drone, as well as Taurus, who's a transporter drone, kind of up front and in their own way kind of tanking. And you can see that they're basically protecting the party, preventing anybody from realistically coming into the area that you see right next to Kylie. That's not to say that the drones can't go on offense either. This is the Ares Assault class drone, and normally my original Ares was kind of a hybrid tank fighter, you know, designed to be at the front while also kind of dealing some damage. This one is much more heavier focus on damage, a lot less health, a lot less armor, and, you know, very similar to Troubleshooters. You can really make them to be whatever you want them to be, you know. Anne can be a damage dealer instead of a healer. Heizing can be a tank instead of a, you know, DPSer. So it's really up to you to design them how you want them to be. Important to note that unlike Giselle, who can realistically only have one pet out at a time, Kylie can actually have two drones at a time. And that's due to a gear piece called Multiple Calculating Device, which you can, of course, craft. There's going to be a lot of crafting revolving around drones and Kylie in general. So certainly, if you're already crafting, this is a great idea to kind of make a second drone. So, of course, we are on 50 Violent right here, and we are fighting Flamecron, who at the moment obviously is at full health. And we have Ares and Gemini. Ares, you're obviously used to. Gemini is a web support drone. It's very interesting to have a dual dynamic between the two because they can make amazing synergy, and we'll show you right here. So for starters, Ares is attacking him, and Flamecron obviously does have fire resistance, so he's not doing as much damage as he normally would. However, he is triggering armor disabling on every hit, so armor disabling is going to be the opposite of armor break, which is basically shredding resistance. So he's already been hit twice with armor disabling, and then you can see Gemini is picking it up with web, and he's just going to keep hitting, and you're going to start seeing over and over each hit is going to be armor breaking. So here's the third hit, you know, here's the fourth hit, and so he's already hit Flamecron four times, and Ares has hit him twice. And as we go up with Elisa, you can see right here that there's four stacks of armor break and two stacks of armor disabling, which in general is devastating for all machines and robots, and obviously excellent use for taking down Destrons as well. So at this point, you know, obviously they're already providing enough utility to the party as a whole. You know, we've already gotten them Flamecron down to 1871. We're actually going to go in with Elisa, and Kylie is actually going to cover Elisa, which then of course triggers a responsive attack from Gemini. And so you know, Flamecron's at like 700 health or so now, and you know, this 977 puts him into overdrive or one health, but because it's a sequenced event, he gets to reattack and of course gets to drop him right away. So not only is their offense and defense stunning, you know, they obviously also have incredible utility too. So Ares obviously just took a hit from Flamecron over there, and to start with, the flamethrower type weapon can do a line attack. You can see he's lighting them up right there, and this has incredible use if you're lining them up correctly. Flamethrower is the strongest weapon of all the weapons that drones can use, and so you'll definitely want at least one flamethrower person in your party, or drone in your party. And you can see, similar to the last one, Gemini is supporting Ares and just completely unloading on him. And you know, even after he breaks it, you notice that Ares is low on health. Well, not low on health, maybe missing a third health and a third fuel. They can also activate survival mode, basically assimilating with nearby robots. So you can see him go for a full heal and full fuel right there. It just makes these things absolutely amazing. Adding even further to their utility is their ability to revive characters. This is an absolutely stunning ability, and obviously you can see Kylie got a little bit out of position here, right? And Taurus is not just a free support that's normally in tandem with Ares. He's also a medic, and he's equipped with emergency rescue system. This will auto revive a character as long as you're very close to them, and very similar to Second Heart, it will be a turn interrupt. Notice that no time has actually elapsed. The Monarch is still ready, the Frog's still at 33 AT. If we go back here before Kylie actually dies, you can see the Frog is also at 30 AT. So right there. And so this is just really awesome if you want to be able to protect your characters. And let's say you've got some squishies in the back row like Hazing or Giselle. This is absolutely perfect for them. Also important to note that all drones start at level 30 and can certainly have promotions. So it kind of does you very well to do power leveling for them. I do recommend my power leveling video if you have not seen that before, as it will help quickly speed up the process to get them in the fight faster and have all their class abilities. This will unlock some masteries for you. And in general, just make this entire process a lot better and have your drones be that much stronger in the actual fight. All right, let's get into actually building a drone. When you finally decide to craft a drone, let's say you're in Silver Lining, go ahead and go to the warehouse. And if you have Kylie unlocked, you should have the machine crafting. You will have to choose between a frame SP type operating system as well as all of its actual parts and equipment, which for a first-time player, this screen can be kind of daunting. But we're going to try and break down each section to make this much more simpler. So very important to note, the frame and SP structure cannot be changed after they are first made and are by far far the most important decisions, so I do recommend you pay extra attention to the next two sections where we'll be going over frame and SP structure. So let's go over each frame choice in a bit more detail. For the frame, you'll have six options: the scout drone, incinerator drone, firefighter drone, transport drone, high-speed drone, and reinforced drone. This will also determine which modules and or masteries will be unlocked at the promotions. So for example, notice down here, these are all the promotions for your drones, and at the final promotion, otherwise known as complete, at class level 16 for the reinforced drone, you'll get the module, or basically mastery for drones, reinforced machine. Now, if you were to go to the scout drone and go to level 16 in the final promotion, you'll get auto fire support. Incinerator drone will get machine control program. Firefighter drone will get emergency rescue system. Transporter drone will get weight management, and so on and so forth. So if you are looking for a very specific mastery and you haven't really built these out yet, you may want to be going for that first. That said, if you're a veteran and you've already been kind of killing machines for quite a while now, and you're just getting into drones, you will have gotten many of the masteries and or modules just from the information on, clearing Schwartz Destron or, Enhanced Destron. And it's been so long that I don't really remember, which each does and all that stuff. But if you're looking for a specific set to build and or mastery, you can certainly go through the rewards and see what each level will actually give you. So for the individual stats from a frame, let's start at the top here because this is specific to the frame information. I would not pay so much attention to the stats. This is very much a expert player thing. So, if this is your first time, for sure, pay attention to the frame information, but not the stats that are all over here. So for the frame information, Maximum loadage determines the maximum weight that the machine can carry and is one of the major factors in deciding a frame. If you go over the maximum loadage, you will not be able to make the machine. Output is essentially total training points for a drone. And then, of course, frame support, reinforcement, security, and AI is equivalent to a human player's basic support, attacks, defense, and ability slots. To better understand which frame you'll be using, we'll actually take a look at their stats first via a quick graph. Obviously, you can see them individually from up here, and as you flip around, you'll see the graph and stats move. But in case you guys actually want to see it as a full comparison, we do have this graph. Special thanks to Nails/Hide for giving this graph, and you guys can essentially pause at any time if you just want to be able to take a look at this. I'll also be leaving a link for this down below in the description. So of all these stats, the three most important are the AI, frame, and maximum loadage. And so you can see all of them kind of in comparison across from each other. And since I actually consider the importance of AI, frame, and maximum loadage in that particular order. So for sure, Scout, Firefighter, and Transporter have the edge over the other three drones for AI slots. And then for frame, Transporter is the highest at 6, with High Speed, Incineration, and Scout Drone at 5. And then, of course, Loadage being the next highest. And based on this, you would think that the Transporter drone is incredible, and it is, because it has the highest frame slots, highest AI slots, and highest maximum loadage. However, you can also compare that it is the lowest output and or training points of all of the drones. So obviously, like all things in Troubleshooter, you certainly have your trade-offs, and I'll go into my recommendations slowly here. But this is really just a great graph to reference back towards. So why do I recommend AI, frame slots, and then maximum loadage? Let's go into it. So you guys have seen the Ares tank assault, I think, on my engineer video. And so the reason why AI slots are so important is because you can do things like module optimization. This is literally going to increase every frame support, reinforcement, and security slot by one. And obviously that's massive. If this was a human troubleshooter mastery, every character would be running this essentially. It also has real-time forward output optimization, which is going to increase your property limits for every module by 3. It has real-time output optimization, which can increase your total output and or what is known as training points for drones by 9. And on top of that, it has some of the sickest abilities in the game. You know, auto dodging response. I'm sure you guys have had to deal with this if you're at endgame, where you unconditionally dodge all responsives no matter what. Survival mode, I showed you guys, is basically its way to assimilate other machines to heal itself. Emergency drive for reviving your characters. Reattack for doubling your attacks. Responsive fire for, you know, doing responsive fires. And so the AI module as a whole is just the strongest, and on many of my boards, you will see it completely maxed out pretty much at all times. So the second biggest one is frame. And this is because you can actually expand the other modules via the additionals. So you can see here, additional AI module obviously is great because AI module is the strongest slot in the game. So this is going to increase the module slots by 2 and increase the property limit for the AI module by 4, which is just totally amazing. And obviously you can do that for security module or, you know, whatever module that you want to expand, you can. And that's why frame is so important and why it kind of comes in second for of importance. Also important to note that, there are mastery sets or drone mastery sets or module sets, if you will, for them. And so you can see additional AI modules. So we're going to expand the AI slot by 2. We're going to expand the security slot by 2. Reinforced machine and then supplementary output control with property limit increase. the mastery set bonus is actually going to give you back a frame module slot. So even though you're using AI slot and you don't really want to use the security slot, you're actually getting the security slot back due to the set bonus. And so obviously there will be lots of tweaking and manipulating as you guys see fit, but it is important to note that, you know, you can really expand your total amount here via the frame slots. And then finally, maximum loadage is pretty self-explanatory. You can see the Ares Mark III tank assault class, his equipment is at exactly 720 out of 720. And we're going to go a little bit further on this once we get down to the equipment section for your drones. So before you guys choose your frame, I also think it's very important to go over drone equipment specializations. For example, the incinerator drone actually deals bonus 10% damage with a flamethrower. I actually don't have one built, so this is actually a good chance to show you guys crafting for it. So obviously you have your machine crafting, but this is specific to the drones themselves. You'll want to go to your workbench and you should have a new unlocked tab, machine crafting. And so we're going to be looking for a weapon specifically. And for today's video, we're actually going to be using just the epics. And generally the epics are always better than any of the blues or greens. So an example, the blue flamethrower, the reinforced flamethrower, does 600 ESP power with a weight of 120. And if we went to the epic flamethrower, it has 720 ESP power with a weight of 60. And if you compare the stats, you'll just see as a whole, the epics are completely better. And so we will be using only these in our comparisons and for the rest of the video. But if you guys saw earlier, I only had the rifle built. And so we're going to build one of every epic weapon. And notice here on the reinforced flamethrower, if the occupied frame is incineration drone, the following effects take place. This is the increased damage dealt by flamethrower. And so while you could put a, let's say, spiderweb launcher on an incinerator drone, you really wouldn't want to. You really do want to specialize. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and craft here. And you can see the requirements here on the right. You know, if you don't have it, then of course collect it. And we're going to build a laser, and then we're going to build one more spiderweb launcher. Alright. And so now, when we actually go to machine crafting and incineration drone, you can see that when I actually put the flamethrower in, it's going to have that bonus to damage dealt by 10%. And these little things start to add up. And so, there are kind of archetypes that we'll be going over, but let's go over some of the specializations through gear real quick. The firefighter drone actually deals bonus 10% damage with a freezing laser. You know, we're gonna start hitting these just really quick. The high speed drone actually gains bonus 20% SP from a high speed engine. Reinforced drone takes less damage when wearing you know, lightweight reinforced carbon heavy armor, black iron heavy armor. High-speed drone gets reduced fuel consumption. Transporter drone gets reduced fuel consumption. Transport drone has increased maximum loadage when equipped with, you know, auxiliary engine Havoc, which is a support gear. And then there's even, you know, sensors that do, if your frame type is information, then the SP gain will be increased by 10%. You know, maximum output, or even, you know, an alternate form of information SP bonus. And so based on all of this information, along with the gearing, along with, you know, all the frames, and obviously this is why this can be pretty complex if you're new to it. As a whole, the incinerator drone is a frontline attacker. And that is kind of like the archetype. And this is because of the flamethrower bonus, and they also have the highest reinforcement attack slots in the game for drones. So, you know, as an archetype, it is a frontline attacker. The firefighter drone is a support attacker defender. You know, obviously you get the bonus to freezing laser, but it also has the highest security slots in the game. And so it does make a pretty good tank, but it does have kind of, you know, reduced frame slots. The reinforced drone, this is your frontline tank, and that's because it gets bonuses to armor. So, you know, if you take black iron heavy armor, you'll see that if the occupied frame is reinforced drone, you just take reduced damage by 5%. So you can see the archetypes slowly come together if you really go through all of the stats and whatnot. The high speed drone is actually a back row support attacker. They gain a lot of SP gain from engine and kind of decreased fuel consumption, and does have the highest support slots of all the drones in the game. And then finally, the transport and scout drones are all purpose. These two are particularly really good. And for your starter drones, unless you have something specific in mind, I do think that these two are the best drones. And this is because, one, they have the highest AI slots available, which is 4 for both of them. Transporter has the highest frame slots at 6. Scout isn't very far behind with 5. Scout does have a much higher output compared to the transporter drone. Let me switch the OS so that you can see the base values here, because multi-processing operating system is actually giving output by 3. I know it's a lot of information. So the Scout drone will have a maximum output of 36, meaning 6. And transporter drone will have 30 output, meaning it will have 6 more training points than the transporter drone will have. You know, so of course you always have your trade-offs. Your transporter drone will have the highest maximum loadage. So, you know, if you're going for like the fully decked out, this is great. But as a whole, these two drones are essentially the strongest in the game. I would just keep that in mind. I would also keep in mind that realistically, not every drone needs to be 10,000 hip. And you should keep in mind that as you place more and more armor on a drone, it will get progressively slower. So, you know, obviously with a maximum loadage, the highest loadage in the game of 700, you would want to put the black iron heavy armor, but notice the negative 28 speed. And, you know, that's what comes with putting on that heavy armor. Whereas in contrast, the lightweight reinforced carbon heavy armor will only be negative 8 speed. And that's a difference of 20 speed. And yeah, that makes a difference towards the end of the game. So, you know, you do have your compare and contrast, but certainly, you know, don't assume that one drone is better than the other. But if you have to assume one is better than the other, I would take transporter drone and scout drone. All right, and let's hit SP types. So machines can choose from 3 different SP types: heating, information, and recharge. And these SP types will determine how the machine gains SP and what bonuses it gets per 5 SP. It will also give the machine an additional module slot. So for heating right here, it's reinforcement, information security, and then recharge is an AI module slot. the SP type will determine which modules will be unlocked at each 8th class level. So, you know, you can see supplementary output reinforcement, but for information, it'll be output transfer device. So you can see how pretty wild that this gets. But really, this cannot be changed. So go with exactly what you want to have kind of at the end, what the main purpose of your drone is going to be. Also important, the machine will also gain resistance to 2 different types of ESP types based on the SP type of the machine. One will be higher than the other. So obviously for heating, you're going to see a fire and ice resistance. For information, you're going to see a water and wind resistance. And for recharge, you're going to see a lightning and earth resistance. That's actually probably not as important as I thought it would be. let's go over how to choose which one you want. So the SP type should not be chosen based off of passives. Starting at the best, heating actually gains 1 speed per 5 heating SP, or meaning at overcharge at 100 SP, he would be 20 speed, and that's not bad. Information is horrible, and so it's going to go 0.1% per 5 information SP, and it's going to increase your hit, dodge, block, and crit chance, which means at 100 SP or overcharge, you will have a 2% increase to all of these, which is obviously horrible. And then finally, recharge. This is going to increase your fuel recovery rate by 1 for every 5 SP. or for a total of 20 fuel recovery rate at 100 SP for overcharge. And in general, you know, the recharge and information passives are horrible. The heating one is not that good either. And so what SP type should be chosen off of is primarily two factors. First should be slot gain. You know, getting an increase to reinforcement slot is not bad. You know, attack slot, especially if you're running, let's say like an incinerator drone that is, you know, generally a frontline attacker, this is pretty great for him, and it just synergizes well. Information is going to get a security slot, so this may be good if you're trying to build a tank drone. Like I said before, I would recommend reinforced and firefighter drone, as they have the highest security slots if that's what you're going for. And then finally, even though recharge has a terrible passive, it does give an AI module slot, making it incredibly good just for that very reason. And then secondly, you should choose an SP type based on gain rate for overcharge abilities. And so we'll start with the highest and then go to the lowest. So heating will actually do 25% of consumed fuel. And this can get pretty out of hand if you're running, let's say, an incinerator drone with flamethrower. You know, my Ares here gains about 21 SP per flamethrower attack. So, you know, it loads up with overheat. You know, it'll be at 100 SP easily at, you know, four attacks or so. So you will quite often see overcharge trigger for him. for information, this is not bad. It's going to give you 5 SP each time you deal or take damage. And so you could do auto reattack and get 2 attacks, and you know, you could get increased SP gain with you know, like let's say high speed drone has a lot of SP gain abilities. So you can get quite a bit, let's say about 9 per attack, you know, if it attacks twice, and maybe 18 or so. It's really not bad as SP gain. And then the worst by far is recharge. And quite literally, you will gain only 5 SP at the beginning of your turn. You will not gain SP for dealing damage. You will not gain SP for taking damage. And so if you're on recharge, it will literally take 20 turns of your drone to get overcharge, essentially making it so you will never see overcharge on a recharge drone on a regular normal map. So it's very important, you know, to kind of choose, you know, how important is your overcharge ability to you. And I will say that the overcharge abilities are not incredibly stellar in the game. So, you know, definitely make it more about the slot recommendation and then about the SP gain, but definitely not about the passives. All right, and now for the operating system structure. So this is great because this can be changed at basically any time. I will not, you know, kind of weigh as heavily on this as I did the frame and SP structure. So there are three types: multiprocessing, open type, and independent. And to start off, we'll go over their passives. Multiprocessing will do output by 3 or 3 training points, which honestly is just basically one skill. It's not that great. Open type will give reduced fuel consumption and increased speed, which is also not that great. And then the independent will increase maximum loadage by 50, which can definitely be a game changer if you're trying to slot in a very specific build. So this passive is definitely pretty good. The other two, not so much. And then, of course, the other passives, this is going to increase, the multiprocessing is going to increase your fuel consumption and reduce cast delay. And so what I like to say here is this can go very well with an incinerator drone. So you're increasing your fuel consumption for every applied module, right? And then you're running heating SP, which gains your SP, heating SP by 25%. And then you're running like an incinerator drone with a flamethrower. And, you know, just to give you an idea, like with Ares here, he has a massive 75 fuel cost. But remember, that's being converted into SP gains. So, you know, everything has its trade-offs, but it's interesting to kind of combine some of these together to have, you know, a much higher synergy. the open type is going to reduce the fuel consumption as a whole. So this is very much like if you really want to have one drone that's just fighting forever. I don't really recommend this because you can hold a dozen or so drones at all times, and so this isn't the best for the passives. And then for independent, recovering fuel will reduce AT, which obviously can be quite good if you're equipping an alternator and all this other stuff. So this is very much kind of build-based. But mostly, these operating systems are in control of the possible personal masteries. And so we're going to go over them very quickly here. Give me 1 second. And so... let's start with multiprocessing operating system, and I'm gonna throw up graphs for all of these. So multiprocessing can do output reinforcement, weapon reinforcement, sensor reinforcement, fuel control, output control, armor reinforcement, auto revenge fire, and reinforcement management. OpenType OS can actually do output reinforcement, weight control, weapon control, fuel control, output control, fuel reinforcement, survival control, and reinforcement management. And then finally, the independent operating system can do output reinforcement, frame reinforcement, driving reinforcement, fuel control, output control, driving control, auto revenge fire, and survival control. And all of these are very interesting and will certainly change your builds drastically as you go through. And this is basically going to be just further and further customization of your drones, and we're not gonna actually like really touch deep on this, but you got kind of an idea of what it's capable of. All right, so all equipment pieces will affect the machine's fuel consumption, speed, current weight. You know, you may get bonuses based on the frame or SP type, but most importantly, weapons will determine your ESP power, your attack power, your hit chance, your crit chance, and your crit damage. And so it is its main attack, it's its SP attack. It's very important. We're going to go over the weapons in a bit more detail here. So the four main types of weapons is the flamethrower, the freezing laser, the assault rifle, and the web launcher. So we're going to start with the ESP weapons here. The flamethrower obviously is ESP type and short distance. This is particularly good on like incinerator drone, who is a frontline attacker, or reinforced drone, which is a frontline tank. Positioning is very important for the flamethrower, so you know, you kind of make your archetype with it. And the trade-off is that the flamethrower is incredibly high damage and incredibly high critical hit chance over the other weapons, so important to keep that in mind. The freezing laser is a ESP type, and this is generally for support drones. It is long distance at 12 range, yes. And it's about medium damage, and it has a very high hit chance. This is cool because you can actually equip your drones in such a way that they can freeze enemies. And obviously this is very good on the firefighter drone. I find it also very good on the transporter drone. And then the rifle is a physical attacker. So this is very good on, like, let's say the scout drone or high-speed drone. It is long distance, it is medium damage, and it has an excellent overcharge ability, similar to Annihilation Shot, like with Heizing, but instead of 11 hits, it's 4 hits. And then finally, we have the web launcher. This is also physical type. It is long distance. It is low damage. However, it does have excellent utility with webbing and kind of sticky spider web. It also has an excellent overcharge ability. So let's check their overcharges really quick here. So Ares has the powerful fire shot, which is the flamethrower overcharge. And you can see it's really just intended to be massive damage like the flamethrower always is. So bonus 50% to still stance, bonus 50% to exposed targets, and just completely nasty. The overcharge for the freezing laser, major differences here is 50% exposed and freezing 50% chance. And so with enough masteries, this is almost guaranteed freezing, which is pretty cool. For rifle, like I was mentioning before, Annihilation Shot, this will do 4 consecutive attacks at pretty high ratio. So you can definitely get some good damage in here, and you can definitely build a drone that kills other, like, let's say, search drones in 4 hits, which is kind of neat. And then the spider web shot is actually going to do a massive sticky spider web AoE, which is particularly awesome. All right, guys, so I know this has been a lot, and to wrap up this video, we are going to actually build a drone. Imagine that. Yay. So I am actually missing a secondary Taurus unit, which is a transporter drone. And obviously I recommended this and the scout drone as kind of your starter drones, just because they're so good. They have what really matters for a drone. And I do consider them kind of like the meta drones, even though, you know, you can make all of these very good. These two kind of stand out for a lot of different reasons, like I mentioned before. For the SP structure, I'm actually going to make him recharge, and that's for the additional AI slot. The operating system I'm actually going to change later, and I would highly recommend that. You don't need to know it right then and there, and this is your first time with drones, don't worry, just pick one, go with your gut feeling and just go for it. So for the weapon, which is very important, I'm actually going to give him the freezing laser. And then for the engine, I'm actually going to do high output, which is the heaviest of all of them. And that's to make up for the deficiency in the transporter drone's output. You can see this is giving +4. For armor, since it is a transport drone with the highest loadage, we're going to go ahead and stack on the black iron heavy armor. You know, we're going to make him nice and beefy, take a hit. And then we're going to add the lightweight hover device, mostly because the high speed and dodge devices are, well, the high speed is meant for the high speed drone. And for the dodge, this dude is not going to be dodging anytime soon. So we're going to save a little weight by going with the lightweight here. And then for the sensor, you get bonus for information type. And obviously, we're not going information type. We're going to recharge. So I do recommend the output. And again, that's the transporter's deficiency. So another +3 on top of the +4 from the engine is +7 output. And that kind of, you know, kind of helps synergize them better. And then for the gas tank, if you notice on the tanks, the occupied frame is transporter drone, you're gonna have reduced fuel consumption. So as a whole, they do pretty well. And at exactly 60 pounds, you can see I've got exactly 700 out of 700 weight. And this is kind of exactly what you wanna do. You kind of wanna use every pound that you get. Could you expand your weight by you know, switching to independent operating system? Yes, you can. I think there's also a personal mastery that can expand weight, but you know, just try and get the rough idea of what you want to be. But this is a good starter drone right here. You know, transport, recharge, all of these right here, and we're gonna go ahead and craft. And so now that he's crafted, he's gonna be assigned a personal mastery, like you saw there. He's gonna be level 30, just like I mentioned, with class level 1. And you know, you're going to see all of his stats and whatnot, and obviously he's going to be missing some output and training points, and you know, he's not even unlocked all of his frames yet. It'll be just like leveling a character, and the mastery board is actually something we're going to get into in the Jordan Guide Volume 2. This is such a massive amount of information, even for me, I don't like going through all of this, so you know. Hopefully this is a good start for you guys. All right, guys, and just wrapping up here, I do have an Excel sheet that I think you'll like. I'll leave a link down below in the description. This is pretty cool, and again, this is set up by Nails/Hide. Yeah, he goes by quite a few names, actually. So this is actually going to have all of the current epics and the category that they're in. And, you know, obviously, so my build was actually this right here for the transporter drone at exactly 700 pounds. You can see all of the formulas have already been put in here. So let's just say I wanted to do the overheat engine. You change this to 0 and put in a 1 for the overheat engine. And then let's say you wanted to do, you know, a large fuel tank. So I'm going to put the medium to 0 and a 1 for large. And you can see that it's updating the weight as it goes. 20 less pounds for the overheat power unit. However, 30 increased pounds from the upgrade from medium to a large fuel tank for a total of 710. This is, of course, over the transporter drone's base limit. And you know, at this point, if you wanted to, obviously, you know, you can see its maximum load is at 700. You could do independent operating system to increase that to 750, and you know, there's lots of ways to manipulate this as you wanted and see fit. But as a whole, this is an excellent guide. It also comes with a tab for frame slots and the incremental actual differences between all six of the drones. So very cool. Again, I'll leave this as a link down in the description. For the drone guide volume 2, that will be next up, and this will include one, promotions, and kind of, you know, like using the operating system's possible masteries. We're obviously going to do mastery boards for drone archetypes, so, you know, tank incinerator and, you know, freeze support medic and web support drone and all that stuff. We're also going to be doing advanced drone mechanics, such as unlocking kind of hidden parts such as the web gun, higher tier drone parts, stronger modules, you know, going into the whole concept behind reinforcement control program, which is massive, massive amounts of critical hit damage and, you know, critical hit chance and all that stuff, and kind of multiple processing and the two set master machine craftsman, and just a lot of the advanced drone mechanics. Again, special thanks to Nails Hyde for the Excel spreadsheets, and if you guys enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Until next time.